This video is going to describe another tool for creating websites. This essentially is a code editor. As you can see on the screen, Visual Studio Code is available from Microsoft. This is a free product, and I'm just going to explore this briefly so you can use this potentially as just another tool to create your web pages. I really like this tool because it's got some nice features. And so if you search for Visual Studio Code, you should be able to find it readily. It's available for both Macintosh and Windows. May even be available for Linux. Indeed, it is. So just about every platform it's supported, and it's very nice because it's the same on every platform. So go ahead and download that. I'm going to move on to the code. I've already downloaded and installed it. Now, to use Visual Studio Code, essentially it assumes you have all your source files and everything in a project folder. So I went out to my Windows Explorer and I created a brand new folder. This folder is empty. I'll double click the folder. You'll notice there's nothing in the folder. And so I'm going to use this folder in Visual Studio and I'm going to add my various files. So I'm going to fire up Visual Studio, and when you get into Visual Studio, essentially this is what you're going to see. It doesn't have any folders or files or anything open. So I'm going to go to the File menu and I want to say Open Folder. And I have to go find that folder that I had recently created. So I'm going to go into my Documents where I put it, and I go into my Classes and I go to CIS 122, and somewhere in here I've got a folder for my JavaScript Online class, and I just created that recently, and you'll notice that I'm stumbling around there. There it is. And there's the folder that I created. So I'm just going to highlight that folder and click the Select Folder button. And so here it is, and you'll notice then it says Project 03. That's the name of my folder, and there's a little drop-down arrow here I could open up and show the files. Now I notice there aren't any files open. So I've got a couple little icons here. I can make a new file, I can make new subfolders, do a refresh, and collapse it, dip back down. So first I'm going to do is I'm going to just make two files. I'll make my first file, my index.html. So there we go, and you'll notice it creates this new file here, and it's got a tabbed interface. Now there's nothing in this index file. So now I'm going to go and I'm going to create another one, and this one I'm going to call it script.js. That'll be for my JavaScript. So now I've got my two files, and I could start editing those two files. Well, I'm just going to do something kind of quick and dirty here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pop back over to my browser, and I'll show you what I can do. I'm going to go to a brand new window, and I'm going to open up the W3 Schools. And on the W3 Schools page, again, this is a resource I've referred you to. You'll notice right on their homepage here, they have this little sample of HTML. So I'm just going to go ahead and open up. I'm not going to open. I'm just going to copy this little sample HTML. Couldn't get any easier. So I'll just go ahead and write, and I'll go ahead and do a Control C for copy here. And now I want to go back to my Visual Studio window. And I'm in my HTML, so I will now paste that, and there it is. And you'll notice how it color codes it and everything. I think if I right click, notice it says Format Document in this right click menu. If I choose that, it then starts doing some nice indenting and spacing, so kind of cleans up your HTML code. So the next thing I want to do is I want to create a link to my JavaScript file. So up here in my HTML, you notice they've got the title. There's no head tag, so I'm going to go ahead and add a head tag here. So I'll just put a head tag in right there. And you know, whenever we put most tags in, we have to close those tags. So just down below the title here, I'm going to slash close that head tag. And we took care of that. Now I'm going to right click and I'm going to do Format Document again. Let's see what happens. Ah, yes, now notice how the title tag is indented inside my head tag. So now I'll go ahead and add my script source. So script source src. There's doing a little pop-up menu here. Notice source equals, and I just hit the tab key, put the equal sign in, the quotes, and the name of my file. Of course, we called it script.js. So then I just close that tag, and then slash script. And there's my closing tag for my script. Now I'm getting some kind of strange errors there. I'm not sure what's going on with that, but oops, I left the R out on script, so that's why it gave me an error. That's nice. Put the R in there, and now everything's happy. So again, that's an advantage of this editor. It understands HTML. That's pretty sweet. Now at this point, I don't have any JavaScript, why don't we go ahead and just put a button in here. So I'll put a button in here, and you'll notice it pops up and it says, you know, button is my first choice, so I can just do that. And I want the button to have an on click handler, and again, notice as soon as I type on, it pops up all these different on click type things. So on CL, and there it is. Now I can hit tab, puts the equal sign in, puts the quotes in there. And so let's just put in a function call here. Notice the name is run code, the open parentheses. I gotta close my button tag there, and now I need some label for my button. So I'll say click me, it's just a generic label. And then I need to close the button tag. And as soon as I type the close slash B, it gives me the pop-up, and I can just hit tab and it completes that. So now I've got a reference here to a function called run code. It'll go to look for that in my script file here. And notice it says control click to follow the link. So if I didn't actually have that file open already, I could control click, and there I am in script.js. So all I need now is a function called run code. So I'll type function run code, open and close parentheses, open curly brace, and it puts my closing curly brace on there. I always like to hit an enter key, and notice it drops that curly brace down, indents ready for me to type some code. And we'll just do something simple here with an alert and just say hello world, our good classic hello world, and then we put a semicolon on the end. So now we actually have some HTML code and we have our script code. And so all we need to do now is try this out. But the thing that I'm constantly forgetting is I'm constantly forgetting to save my files. So I'm going to go to the file menu and choose save all. Oh, look at, they added a new feature, auto save. I'm feeling good about that because I was always forgetting to save things. Nice. So at this point, I've got a web page and a little script behind that web page, and I just need to view it. So that means I need to go find my index.html. So I have my index.html right here in my Explorer window. And so I can now open this up with a web browser. So Firefox is my default web browser, so I'll just go ahead and double click that. So here it comes. So there is my little HTML page that we just opened. And you notice it's got the click me button and it's got that default text. We didn't change that. So I'm going to go ahead and click the button, and it should do the little alert that says hello world. Click. There's the hello world alert, so the JavaScript is working like a champ. So this was a very quick introduction to Visual Studio Code. If you make any changes, let's just go ahead and make a quick change. So I'll just change this H1 heading, and we'll call this Hello Visual Studio Code. We'll change our paragraph tag here, put some different text in our paragraph tag there. Let's say this is a great editor, cross-platform, and autosave is on, so let's check. Yes, indeed, so it's auto-saving that. That means we should just go back over to our browser window. We can do a reload in our browser window here. I'm just going to do a Control-R for reload. Now it says, hello, Visual Studio Code. This is a great editor. And again, my click me button does what it did before. And everything's working like a champ. So the process then is simply to create your files. And you'll notice how easy that was to create my files. You want to start with a folder that exists, though, so that you can choose the file menu and say open folder. It'll be an empty folder to start with, of course. Then you just simply add some files to your folder. Here we added the index and the script files. Edit those files to have the content that you want. Everything gets automatically saved, and then you go find that file in its folder where you've stashed it. Open that up with your browser, and you can view it. And then all you need to do to remember after you change it is to do a reload on your browser, and reload typically on most browsers is just Control R to do a quick reload button. So anyway, quick and dirty, off you go, and I would encourage you to take a look at Visual Studio Code. It's a nice little program, it's free, and I really applaud Microsoft for making this thing available.